You may have thought it was over, but it's just getting started. The Basic ENET tutorial series. What a journey it's been for me, and I bet for you too. We've all learned so much, and I'm so excited for things to come. Before we get started, a couple of you have taught me some quite interesting things, and I must thank you not just for the support, but your active participation. I honestly can't believe it. First, I just want to mention that someone by the name of Alexandre Giroff, I hope I didn't butcher that, has created a more optimal version of the chat screen files for the Simple Chat project. 100% written in C as well. I just find that awesome. Now let's review what I could have done differently with BubblePop's networking. Number 1, mem functions. So I'm new to C, and every day I get a little better. But one of you, Harry Pixels, wrote a simple example program that explains the proper way I should have been doing things, and I clearly saw that what I was doing, though functional, was thoroughly overcomplicated. I could have simply copied bytes of data from one area in RAM to another. It would have worked automagically. Just copy raw bytes into a float. I didn't know we could do this, but now I do, and it makes a lot of sense. Number 2, buffers. In fact, just one big buffer. This is a rather simple concept I should have added. Rather than sending one packet at a time, we batch all the packets together, and since they already have a header, we can simply identify every packet from there. We can conceptualize all the packet types with different structs, with different headers. We can do this by checking the first byte, and if identified, we can then copy that byte to that byte plus the size of whatever packet it ended up being based on the header's value. Then we know the next packet is at the last byte plus 1. We can simply go through the array of bytes in that manner, making sure to know when we've reached the end by perhaps having the very first byte represent the number of bytes within the array, or something like that. Which leads me to number 3, an event system. I've made them in the past, but I have not applied them correctly, I don't think. BubblePop basically has some kind of pseudo event system that only the networking engine really cares about. One fun thing is, if I made the packets actual events that could be triggered by simply parsing the array of bytes, then I could calculate a frame, then send all the triggered local events to the server so that the server may parse them. And that makes things so simple. We literally synchronize key events. It's like calling a function on someone else's computer. And we assume the server is reality, and we synchronize everyone else from there. Clients shouldn't tell the server what to do, merely suggest. The server tells the clients what to do. They have, number 4, authority. I don't actually have much to say about this, just that authority should be something that I discussed in future videos, that as well as the event system. I may have thought that I was teaching you, but it would seem that you are the ones teaching me. Only 7% of the people who watch user games are actually subscribed. If you subscribe, know that it's free and fills me with glee. The future holds a mystery, one that I am set to discover. I'm not entirely sure what it is, but I know it's something special. Stay tuned for an eventual advanced ENET tutorial series, and perhaps other bigger projects. I'll see you then.